Good morning. How's it going? Today is a new day. Oh, yeah. Good stuff. It's fun times. Let's see. So today I generated another gamut mask over there. So it'll be fun to see what I can do with that gamut mask. Good morning, Eric. How's it going? We got 1,223 followers. We are inching closer and closer to the 1,500 one. That being said, let me to see if I can't change that. No. There we go. Save settings. Restart. Does it change? It doesn't. Let's see if we log out and log back in. Does it update the stream? Oh no. Something's happening. Let's see if it updated. Oh, it didn't update. I probably have to restart the stream. Anyways, good morning, Eric, Atski, Kuru, Lurib, Zabi, Kuru, again. TMH Laba, thanks for the auto host. I'm good, thanks. Yeah, so this is the swatches or the gamut mask. Let's see. Let's see. So let's throw some topics my way. Roll the dice and see which topic I'm gonna do today. Exciting, exciting. So throw me some topics my way. And shout out to Law Santer, who's the latest follower. You have entered the fold. There's no going back now. Master777 Oz, thanks for the host. So we got one, two, three topics. We got First Contact, King of the Jungle, Cursed Fairy. Ooh, that could be cool. The Cat from Alice in Wonderland. Ooh, that's nice. Whatever that one's called. It's called something specific. Nasty Witch. That's pretty cool. I hope it's Nasty Witch, to be fair. All right, we got five. Now we got six. Dinosaur Land. Right, let's. Why aren't you working? I just made you work before the stream. And now it doesn't want to work, right? Here we go. Which one is it? Number four. Rigged. One, two, three, four. The Cat from Alice in Wonderland. All right. Whatever that. Cat from Alice by Lou. I gotta go and look at the cat's name. Whatever the cat's name is after the stream. Right, let's do it. Number four, obviously rigged. What a stupid laugh came out of my mouth. It is what it is. I can't really do anything about it. All right. So, let's see. Let's see what happens today. I want to paint something again. The cat from Alice in Wonderland. So, maybe kind of warmer tones in the shadow. Like again? Let's do that again. Obviously, we got way more greens. Maybe yellow in the background or blue in the background. Yeah, let's go with blue in the background. And I wanna, I see him kind of float, and there's like a branch, obviously the classic branch, but he's floating. It's a he, right? So I want to contrast here in the middle, right? I want the contrast point to be around the face. And I want him to kind of float around a bit, you know, like the cat, you know, like he does in the movie with the tail. Kuru, yeah, I mean the handmade dice was nice. I liked it. I quite enjoyed the handmade dice. But there's too many people complaining. Right, so I want to have, think I'll go with, obviously, it has to be cold shadows. Well, I'm kind of enjoying it. This is cool. The Cheshire Cat, yeah, or probably butchered the how pronunciation of it. Cheshire. Yeah, that's the name. Let's put some. I want to have. Let's put some darker value in there. I want it to be a dark top, the most contrast around the head, and the brighter further down. I like this gamut mask challenge. It's very interesting. It does a lot of things to my mind, which is interesting. I was watching on Discord. There was I don't remember who now. Obviously, no, or typically rather, I'm horrible with names. But someone posted a link about values in the useful links section. I had a look at it, and that guy definitely knows how to explain things really, really well. Was quite nice to hear. He explained it really nice with values and so on. So whoever's on Discord, I'd say you go and listen to that little video about values. Was really cool. Hey Nifas, good morning. Eric, yeah. Swatches. It was really good. Like it really took time to explain the kind of the setup of what he wants to explain, and then he explained it clearly. It's really, really hard to do that, and obviously he has been teaching a lot. You can hear it in the way he talks, Besides also what I think what he has in comparison to, let's say, me, who tries to teach on my spare time, I think he has the ability to, he's obviously a freelancer and not a full-time artist, in that sense that he has a 9 to 5, he has a Patreon, which allows him to spend time. I'm thinking of where to put the nose of the cat. The cat has a huge mouth, right? We should have probably some sort of desaturated blue first, because I want to punch the show the mouth. So I want to put some saturation or this red in there around the lips. Shmays, I think, I mean, it would be an option, but it has to be a calculated move in a bigger scale. But I mean, I'm really happy where I'm working at the moment. I have no plan of changing. But I would love to have more time for education. I mean, that's a that would be a in a way like ideal situation where I could do both, right? I mean, I do teach at the studio. I do help the guys, and all these things, But ideally, some time to focus on education at the same time as having time to design for games, movies. And the biggest issue why like it wouldn't be an option at the time is that I have a family. And if you gotta do a move like that, it has to be a calculated one because the whole family is dependent on my income. And it wouldn't be cool to screw my family over just because I wanna not follow my dreams, but yeah, follow my dreams. Wow, the cat's eyes. I do like that they're really wonky and it looks like a really weird pug. I like that idea. I mean, we could do that cat eye, or we could do the I love you cat eyes, or I'm gonna eat you cat eyes. Let's do that. That's awesome. I have a cat. Her name is Princess. No, Lady Sansa, not Princess. Lady Sansa. It's a black cat, and she's super princess-like, like spoiled in a way, but by nature, she acts like a little princess. Regardless, what was getting to? Yeah, so I've been playing a lot with the cat. Obviously, when you got a cat, you play with him, and what I love is when you kind of when they get ready to attack, they just stare, and you can see like how they're physically preparing to attack. Like they charge up the body. You can see like they're loading up. The eyes, the irises of the eyes grow. You know, they want to take in as much information as possible, you know, take in as much light as possible, so that when they do make their move, they're completely ready to take with a change, you know, rather than really short, small, narrow pupils, which means less light being taken in. You know, so for me, it's really cool to see the cat and how they get so ready to attack. You know, it's crazy. It had some sort of stripes, right? Tiger stripes, kind of. Or is that to Michael Kutche? The Cheshire cat. It has stripes, right? The striped cat. That's what it is. Should really make those eyes really, really deep. Let's keep those stripes in. I'm not really a cat guy, to be honest. My family has always had dogs, but the cat is the first pet as an adult, and the kids loves cats. Wife, I think wife loves cats the most. So obviously, we were getting a cat. You see, using these gamut masks, for me, it makes some really interesting results. I definitely want to expand this process and come up with a way to automate it somehow. I mean, you could, like, if you have these swatches, right? You could make a decision saying, these blues are the darker tones, the yellow greens are the brighter tones, and you make a gradient based on them, and then you apply it to you apply it to the black and white sketch. I mean, theoretically, then you would get a palette that's consistent. Yeah, that's interesting. I gotta try that as like a boost start for the palette and the. I mean, obviously, painting it from scratch makes your decisions matter more, right? The decisions I make are all based on color from the beginning and not really value. But I think that could be an interesting experiment. I mean, obviously, it will be less painterly in that way because now there's a lot of decisions being made where I'm putting down color at the same time as value. And I think if you did grayscale with this on top, it wouldn't be as expressive, but maybe the trade-off is fine. Hey, Gaxix, good morning. Want to have some color in there. Let's put some. Yeah, I think that's gonna be tomorrow's experiment. If we can do a grayscale sketch and then apply custom gradient map on top of it based on a random gamut mask, and if the palette becomes interesting that way. I think so. I think. I mean, I can't really see too much problems with it as a setting up a basic palette and treatment, and then obviously you have to continue painting on it on top. But I think that should be fine. Think that would be fine. This cat looks stupid. Yeah, I'm thinking about the process. It should work. Shouldn't really be without problems. Unfortunately, currently for work, I'm doing line art, and I can't experiment with that process. But I will definitely experiment with it and see if it would work. I think it would. I love that. I love like trying out the new process and trying to figure out how to streamline it so that you change your approach. Hey, Rogue 13 poll account. Thanks for the host. Much appreciated. Now, I feel like I need to have some sort of backlight, and I'm thinking of what color should be introduced as backlight. Maybe this super green. Let's try it. Let's add some like rim light too. Yeah, that would, I think that would work. Need to have it down here, then brighter. Does that make sense? I don't know. Good morning, Svensson. Purple light. Could do that too. What's the purple? The purple is not really purple. I can't change, move away from the palette, but I think I'll just use white. And not have it so much of it down here. And boost the contrast. You know, I enjoyed the wonky eye, but it's working against me at the moment. It doesn't feel like cat eyes. I gotta make it a little bit more cat-like. And broader smile. Hey, dear bard, welcome. Glad that you could make it. Okay, where are we? 8 minutes left. All right. Thanks. Yeah, it's Lou Ribs. He wanted the Cheshire Cat. Cheshire. Should try to put some character in his hair. And try to make it feel like fur as well. And not just perfect lines. Dear Bard, 50% value contrast with it. I'm not sure what you're asking, but the palette, I think it's just color, and you have to add the darkness and brightness to it. Obviously, you should only with darker tone rather than shifting the hue. No, I don't know if that is what you were confused about, or maybe I'm the one confused. But obviously you gotta adjust it up and down in the window to get the correct darkness. I think I have to mention again that this is, I don't know the technique, this is experimentation. I really got to go and read James Gurney's book about the color swatches, because that's where I got the idea from. And I haven't done this before, so I don't know how to do it correctly. So this is purely experimental, but it seems to be working. I don't know. Right. I think the gray here is just mid, absolute mid range from this website. I mean, you could adjust it, but I just went with default setting and took a triangle and rotated the triangle, you know, so that I got a random palette. I didn't go in and tweak any settings or do anything like that whatsoever. There's obviously room for that. I think you can also change the gamut mask that way, but as it is, I think I'm just adding black and white to the gamut mask to go up and down in value rather than change the hue. Think that should be a valid way to do it. Like I said, again, this is pure experimentation. I gotta go and read the book. A lot of decisions like this through my career, I've done on an emotional basis, just kind of reacting to what I'm seeing rather than with knowledge or limitations. I mean, I've set the limitations to my palette on my own rather than predetermined like this from a mask, gamut mask. So this is a really interesting process for me, and I think I will grow from this experience. Which I think I've already been doing these two times. That's fun. I'm looking forward to do more of these and see where it leads. Hey, Kuiba. Good morning. Welcome back. Yeah, exactly, dear Bart. So that's the idea, right? That you can sample it and go up and down and sideways, but not change the hue of it. Because in the, I remember in his book, he defines, before he starts painting, he defines what's the main color, what's the accent, all these things, you know, before even starting to paint. I am obviously going the other way around where I'm deciding those things on the fly, for better or for worse. But so far, it's been working. I don't like those things. Should try to. So 1 minute left. Oh my God. On a side note, look, on a personal matter, my daughter, who some of you know, she's got autism. She's lately been improving. She took a leap, like all kids do now and then, but it's extra evident in her because she has significant speech delay and issues. But she lately she's been singing a lot, and her favorite songs, currently her favorite song is the You're Welcome song from Moana. It's so cute to hear her try to sing it. It warms my heart. Cute little girl. Oh yeah, one last thing before I call it time. But this is what I ended up looking like. Dear Bardi, she loves to draw, but she can't draw things. She draws doodles, but she can sit for a really long time and doodle, like making circles and lines and things. Yeah, so this is what it ended up looking like. The Cheshire Cat. Thanks for the topic, Lurib. I wish you all a fantastic day. Good night. Wherever you are, whichever time zone you are in. No, that decision was bad. Made it starting to become a pirate. But yeah, see you guys tomorrow morning. And do come and hang out in the Discord. I'm there off and on when time allows me, because, you know, day work, client work, and all those things. Yeah. Have a fantastic day. Thanks, everyone. Bye. Here comes the outro. Wow.